And I've got so much to thank Him for, so much to praise Him for, where You see. Now He's been so good to me. And when I think of what He's done and where He's brought me from, I've got so much to thank.
Good evening. We welcome you to another Good News broadcast. Good to be back this week. We're short-staffed tonight, so we're going to be doing some changes. We have Brother Joe with us tonight. He's going to be speaking to you later on in the program. We have Brother Gilbert, Brother Bill, Brother Gerald with us, and they'll be singing. And they're probably going to maybe sing like three songs in a group while I answer the telephones. So be sure and call in your prayer requests. But just bear with us because we are short-staffed. Sister Judy is sick. She's having some respiratory problems, so she's not here. So we don't have anyone to answer the phones. But just bear with us, and we work out the best way that we can. I'd like for you to remember Betty Johnson over in Statesville in prayer. She's not feeling well tonight. Also, like for you to remember Kathleen and Edward Patterson from down in Statesville. And we want to send a special song out to all of our listeners, and especially to those who have requested prayer. We ask you that you remember them in prayer. We're going to let Brother Gilbert and them go ahead and bring us some songs, and then I'll be back in a little while with some more prayer requests. Go ahead, Brother Gilbert.
Made them just for me. Gerald's gonna sing in the garden.
Like to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice that I hear falling on my ear, the sound of keeps calling me, and he walks with me,
and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there.
Sound of his voice is so sweet that the birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart keeps calling me. And he walks with me,
and
he talks with me,
and he tells me I am his own,
and the joys we share
as we dance.
Stay in the garden with him till the night time around me has fallen, but he bid me to go with a voice of woe. The Son of God keeps calling.
Good to be back on the Good News program tonight. A little bit short, but we're going to make it. go ahead. A chord.
I've heard of a land of joy and peace and wonderful life, a beautiful place of mansions fair, skies ever bright, where all who believe the Savior dear forever shall stay. And having been saved by grace divine, I'm going that way. Savior may know, I want them to sing his praise above some beautiful day. For glory to him who died for me, I'm going that way. I'm going that way.
I'm going that way.
I'm going that way.
Going that way.
And Jesus the Savior I adore is with me each day. I'm clinging to him, and never to stray,
and nevermore stray.
Singing his praises all day long, I'm going that way. I know I shall meet him at the gate. When trials are past, I know I shall meet him face to face in glory at last. And oh, I believe that when we meet, well done he will say, for trusting his soul redeeming love, I'm going that way. I'm going that way. Savior I adore is with me each day. I'm clinging to him and never to stray. Singing his praises all day long, I'm going that way.
Ask you that you remember Robert Tollison in prayer. A listener has called and requested prayer for her shoulders. They both are hurting and wanted to hear the song Amazing Grace. Bobby Weaver, and he needs prayer for him and the family. Barbara Sis has asked prayer for Joanne Cook. She is in a very serious condition. She's very sick with the different types of flu. And remember the family. The Albert Stone family wants prayer. And also remember Rosie, who is in the rest home in Florida, and she needs prayer. Jeff Kaiser passed away this afternoon, and the family would like for you to remember that family in prayer. Frankie Drum needs prayer, and today is her birthday, so happy birthday, Frankie, to you. And we pray that you will have a good recovery from your surgery. Remember Ernest Earp and his mother, Mary Earp, who is having some problems with her legs. Like for you to remember Sister Judy Crider. She's the one who usually answers the telephones and takes the prayer request, but she has some respiratory problems. And also, I ask you still remember Lonnie and Donna. Lonnie's taking the chemo. He is working on Saturdays and it really drains his energy and drains it. Sister Cindy called me, and she don't know really when she'll be back on the program. Her mother, the cancer that she has, is a very aggressive type cancer, and they're saying that there is nothing that they can do for her other than, you know, it's one of those kind that the chemo wouldn't do her any good, and they feel like that it's not worth her going through the stress of taking the treatment. So just remember Cindy and her family. Remember her mom. You know, this is what I like. When the doctors say that they've done all they can do, then the main doctor steps in, and that's Dr. Jesus. There's nothing that God can't do. If we have faith as the size of a grain of mustard seed, and we ask in faith, believing, and doubt not, God said he'd give us the desires of our heart. If we ask in faith, believing, and not doubting, and I know it's so easy to doubt things because it's like we live in a negative world. But, you know, we must have faith in God, put our trust in God. I also ask you to remember me in prayer. I have a personal need, and God knows what that need is. But, you know, we are supposed to let our requests be made known. And I'm asking you to remember me in your prayers. And I wanted to share some letters with you that I got this week. A listener here says, we listen every Saturday night. It really helps me. May God continue with the program. I miss y'all when you're not on. We enjoy watching the program on Saturday night. Would like to hear till the storm passes by. We will be praying for the program. Thank you for spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. God bless you and your ministry, your friends in Clover, South Carolina. Also, it says, hi, Pastor Varner. We have been watching you on Saturday nights. We are from Charlotte, and we're in our 70s and 80s, and we don't get a lot, but do watch the TV. Please sing Amazing Grace if you can, and also Broken Pieces. We have another letter from a listener in Monroe who watches the broadcast and saying that they hope it all is going well. And says, here's another one, says, I enjoyed the program Saturday night. It was so strongly here. I did not get to see it all, but what I saw was good. Pray for my back, legs. They hurt so bad. Sing me a song. I am praying for you, and may God take care of you. Here's a listener who said that they had started giving to the program, have never stopped. Maybe every once in a while, they've missed hearing their names called out and their prayer request, and we apologize to that. We don't mean to forget anyone. But there's a lot of mail, a lot of things to go through, and sometimes we do miss getting your name and your request, but we always pray for everyone's request, and God knows what we all have need of, and says, we love your program and hope we will always be able to support it. God bless you. We appreciate that. And also, we just praise the Lord for these who have given. We're going to let Brother Gilbert and them go ahead and bring you about three, maybe four more songs. And thanks been requested that Gerald sing I Believe. And Gerald, you just might as well, when you sing it, go ahead and do it twice.
We'll send this song out with Brother Jimmy Fox here.
We can see it above. shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet.
Keep me safe till the storm passes by. has ended, and the storms sound no more. Let me stand in thy presence on that bright, peaceful shore, in that land where the thunder never sounds. Lord, may I dwell with thee, where no storm will ever pass by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds stand in the hollow of your hand. Keep me safe till the storm passes by. Keep me safe till the storm passes by.
When I see the sunrise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face, when I hear the sound of children play,
I believe that he gave
life for me.
Do you believe that he gave his life for you? He gave his life for the whole world. But it seems the whole world doesn't want him. But he wants you. He wants your heart. He wants to save you. He wants to heal you. He wants to supply your every need according to his riches in glory. Do you believe in a man called Jesus? I do. I know he can do what man can't do. When doctors say that there's nothing they can do, but there's one greater and higher and mightier than man, and his name is Jesus. Ed Turbeville, Herschel Reed, Alton Clark, and Ruth Reed and family all needs our prayers. Bertie Atwood is an assisted living facility in Morganton, and there's been prayer requested for her. Enjoying the program and have asked prayer for Tim Green. Alden Wheeler is in the Caldwell County Hospital in Lenore. He's on a respirator. He's in very serious condition, so please remember Alden in prayer. Charlotte Little in Concord, from Concord, needs prayer. Mary Plameo, Nancy DeRoach, needs prayer. Nancy is having problem with swelling in her legs. Also, Paul Smith has a lot of issues with his health. We need to lift him up in prayer. Also, Sandy Chambers has fell and gotten hurt and needs our prayers also. So I ask you that you remember these dear folks in prayer. I want to say thank you for your gifts to the Good News broadcast, for the Good News program. We thank our friends from down in Clover, South Carolina. We have Donald and Betty from down in Concord, Roe and Paulette from Charlotte, Gerald and Wilma from Harrisburg, North Carolina, Robert and Jeannie from down in Monroe. We have Glenn from in Pinola, Carolyn and Mike from Concord, Bobby from Gastonia, Dorothy from Morganton. We had a listener from down in Rock Hill, South Carolina. And we have Lee and Linda Epley from Morganton, Mary Lou from Hickory, William and Elizabeth from Charlotte, and Trula from up in Crumpler, North Carolina. And we appreciate you that have given on this broadcast. I'm going to ask Brother Dockery to come and join with me. We want to go to the Lord in prayer, and we want to pray for you. I want you to trust in God. I want you to believe in the Lord. Prayer does change things. God is able, and he's never failed us. He never will fail us. There's nothing that our God can't do, and we want to go to the Lord in prayer, and then he's going to be bringing us the message tonight. Yes. Our Father in heaven, Lord, yes, as we approach your throne tonight, we come to you in the lovely name of Jesus, your precious Son. We ask you, Almighty God, that you would have mercy upon those that are sick and suffering in their body, Lord. Touch Lonnie and Donnie and Judy, and touch all of these, Lord, that have called in the names tonight, Lord. We claim their healing, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Yes, Father. We ask you, Lord, to touch them, Lord, and deliver them, Lord, from their suffering and from their pain, Lord. Remember them, Lord Jesus. Remember their families, Lord. Remember those that have gone on to be with you, Lord. Remember their families, Lord. Give them comfort, Father.
That one, and bless that your name word tonight, above Father. Every name,
bless
Father.
Our brother, Lord.
Name
He's going to
Jesus,
bring your word
Savior,
tonight, Lord.
Lord. May there be hope Hallelujah found of our lives. We bless you
soul,
and thank you, Father,
need, Lord.
For the
Father,
move of thy Spirit
yes,
and power
yes,
in
Jesus'
name.
In mighty name we ask it, Lord. Amen. Brother Joe, go ahead.
Blessed be the Lord. Blessed be my Father, my Savior, my Lord, my Master, my Redeemer. He is the Holy One of Israel. and I love the Lord and he loves me. I'm his adopted child, and ain't nothing the devil can do about it. I'm more than a conqueror through Jesus, who loved me and gave himself for me, and I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. That's what the Word of God says, and I have the Word of God within my heart. Father, my yellow boku shilana. Like David said, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you, Lord. That's the way the child of God is going to have the victory and live in the victory. Are you living in the victory lane today? Are you walking in the straight and narrow way that leads in at the straight gate? Few be there that's going to find it. Are you sure you're all right with the Lord? Is everything right between your soul and your Savior? The blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, cleanses us from all sin. Not half of them, maybe so, but all sin. We can rely upon the word of the living God. Jesus said, I came not to judge the world. Jesus didn't come judging anybody. He always spoke mercy, not judgment upon them, unless they were a Pharisee or a Sadducee or a great high priest. He called them a generation of vipers. All the church, the religious ones, were against him. And that's the way it is today. All the big religious churches and everything, they don't preach the glorious gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. They say, come to church and God will make you rich. My Bible tells me the man's wealth does not consist in the abundance of the things that he possesses. That's what God's word says. But if you be like Abraham, be the children of Abraham like God said ye would be, in Abraham, in thy seed, shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. Not seeds as of many, but in thy seed. Jesus is the seed of Abraham. He's that seed that God promised Abraham, that all the nations of the earth would be blessed through Abraham. Isaac, Jacob, all the good promises of God from here, way here to here. This is the infallible word of God. I know there's 15, 20, 30 different versions, but there's only one true word that the Holy Ghost bears witness to. When I hear the other words, the Spirit don't move in me. But when I read here, let me read what people, like Timothy. Paul loved Timothy. I had a man to tell me one time, you know, Paul, he was married. He first told me, he says, you know what I am? And I said, no, I don't know what you are. I think you're a child of God, ain't you? No. I'm Jesus only. And he says, I read today where Paul was married because he had a son. I'd have kept my mouth shut and walked away. I knew he didn't know what he was talking about. This is Paul's son, Timothy and Titus. If you're a young minister and you think one day that you want to be a pastor of the church, a bishop of a church, you need to read the epistles to the pastors, to those that wants to be pastors. If any man desire the office of bishop, he must be husband of one wife and go on, but I'm not going into that today. But Titus, he was his son in the faith. We're all the sons of God. Join heirs with Jesus. But listen what Paul tells Timothy. Chapter 4. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly. Do you hear what Paul said? Now the Spirit. What Spirit? The Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God. And when the Spirit of God speaks, you better take heed to it. What did the Spirit say, Paul? The Spirit speaks expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies and hypocrisy. We're living in that day, my brothers and sisters, in the latter times. Forbidding to marry. Does not the Catholic Church forbid everyone in the church? They can't have a mate. What did God say about man? It's not good that man be alone. But here it says they will forbid to marry, and they will even command to abstain from meats. They do that too on Friday. When I was in Ohio, I heard everybody talking about, well, the Catholics don't eat meat on Friday. But they turn around and say, well, we eat fish on Friday, ain't that meat? See, that's how the devil has got people's minds so mixed up. Listen what it says. Forbidding to marry, commanded to abstain from meat, which God hath created, he created in chapter 9 and 10, after the flood, God gave Noah meat of the animals to eat. Before then, they were vegetarians. Even the animals were vegetarians. Even after that, God made the predators to eat those that were lame of the animals and everything. Read it for yourself. Before the flood, everything, the animals and humans were all vegetarians. And he says, as I have given you evergreen herb, I also give you the meat, but the blood thereof, which is the life thereof, you shall pour out unto the ground. You shall not eat the blood, for all the life is in the blood. That's the reason Jesus on the cross shed his holy, sinless blood for you and I, that he might redeem us. God said, I give unto Moses in the wilderness, I give it to you upon the altar as an atonement for your soul, your eternal soul. But we don't listen to the word of God. We listen to denominations, and that's what has burnt the church today. We got so many people believing so many things and won't read the Word of God to find out the truth about the things. For every creature of God is good and nothing to be refused. All you people that refuse to eat meat. If you're going to a place that don't refuse to eat meat and say we don't eat meat here and we don't eat meat that, you need to go somewhere where they obey the Word of God. You need to get out of the Catholic churches and you can eat meat any day of the week. For every creature of God is good, nothing to be refused, if it be received with thanksgiving. If you will thank God for what he has given you, and bless him, and listen how Paul says it is sanctified to you. For it is sanctified by the word of God. God saying it's good for you, eat it. And what? By the word of prayer. I don't eat nothing unless I ask, thank God for it. And by the word of prayer and thanking God and knowing that God says I can eat it, then it's sanctified unto me and I'm holy in what I eat. Because whatever I do it as unto the Lord and not unto man. We serve God and not man. We need to look unto our Lord, our Savior, and to his holy, precious word here, and let his word be our guide and not man. Let every man be a liar, but let the word of God be truth. Ain't that what the word says, preachers? Brother Smith, I believe you might be watching, and I love you. You've always been an inspiration. I've never been around you much, but you and your wife is an inspiration to me. When I was in the Kings Creek Church of God, and we had fellowship together and everything, I was hungering and thirsting for somebody to preach on the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and that little preacher came down there from up in Virginia, and I said, well, I'm going up there. I ain't going to church tonight. I'm going up there to South Lenore to hear him preach. And thank God he preached on the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Then North Lenore, the next week, they had a revival. A different preacher was preaching. I went up there one night, and Brother Smith preached on the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Only two preachers I'd ever heard preaching on the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Preach it, brother. I'm going to preach the word of God. I don't care what the devil does. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Listen what the word of God says. 2 Timothy 3:1-8. Know this also, in the last days perilous times shall come. Here's 20 things that they're going to be doing. For men shall be lovers of their own self. They will be covetous. They will be boasters. They will be proud. They will be blasphemers. They will be disobedient to parents. Have you ever seen a day in which we live that children don't have no respect for their parents? They tell the parents what to do. The parents don't tell the children anymore. I know it in my own family. When little so-and-so said, "Don't you want to go?" She got to go to grandma's house because she said she didn't want to go. We need to tell children what they need to do and love them and take us with us and everything and let them know the things that are out here in the world and teach them in the right way and not pawn them off on grandma. Disobedient to parents, unthankful. You can do something for somebody today and they don't even say thank you. I experience it all the time. Unholy. Without natural affections, they're perverted in everything they do. They do it contrary to the will of God and to the word of God, and they're perverted in their lifestyle, walking in sin, gross sin, homosexuality, immoral, living ungodly. God says it's abomination unto me. All the filthiness, but we're compromising with the devil. It's all demon power. The demons possess people that's living in homosexuality, leaving the natural use of the woman and turning to man, burning within lust of the flesh. Without natural affection, truce breakers. How many people you know today that you can trust what they say? They'll say one thing and they'll do another. You can't put no confidence hardly in no people today. Even them that go to church and claim to be Christian, claim to be Christ-like. They'll tell you, "Well, I'll meet you at 3 o'clock and we'll go do this or that," and it's 5 or 4:30, it's not 3 o'clock. God wants us to be like him. Honor your word. When I tell somebody I'm going to be there at 3 o'clock, if I can't make it, I'll call them on the cell phone and tell them I ain't going to be able, brother. It might be a little bit late. But most people, they don't care. They call themselves Christians. Anybody calls themselves Christian, but there's very few disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ. Disciple, a disciplined one. One that really loves God and God really loves him because he's walking in the best that he knows how. As the light has shined on his path, he walks in the light of God's word. And it's a lamp unto my feet. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. It's a light unto my path. And I walk in the light of God's holy word. I do what God's holy word says for me to do. I don't do what man says, well, you ought to do. Do what your father tells you to do. People today, children today, they don't do what their parents say to ask them to do. No, I don't want to go. Well, I went with you and took you to the doctor. Why don't you want to? I just don't want to go. I'm going to go up and stay with grandma. Anything child don't want to do today, they just, I don't want to do it. Well, poor little thing. Truce breakers. Can't never tell the truth. False accusers. They'll tell a lie on you to their own good, if they can get something by telling a lie on you, if they can down you and make people think less of you and what is right, they'll do it. Me and mine, and us four, no more. You get the best, we got ours, you get the best way you get yours the best way you can. That's the way of the public today. That's the way the devil has all the kingdoms of this world today. He offered them unto Jesus, and he said, all these things I'll give you. They were delivered into my hand, and I will give it to whomsoever I will. Yes, he took it every bit that God put dominion in the hands of Adam. Adam gave dominion over the world. Everything was in the world, everything that breath, everything that fly in the air, and everything that hath breath in it, I give unto your hand. I give you dominion to rule over everything that I have made, Adam. Heed him, let him be part of his restoration of the earth and bringing it back into habitable part for man and beast and animals and all things that are in the world today. God let Adam be a part, but he let every Adam be. Name every animal, every bird, every fowl of the air, and whatsoever Adam called them, that was the name thereof. But people today, they're after the world, and the Bible expressly says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but it's of the world, and the world's passeth away, and the lusts of it, lust thereof. It's going to pass away. The flesh, you're lusting in the flesh, walking in the flesh, walking carnal and not spiritually minded. We need to have the mind of Christ. Let this mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus. What kind of mind did he have? He had a mind to love and serve the Father and do the Father's will, and that's the same mind that I have tonight. I want to do what my Heavenly Father wants me to do. That's the reason I'm standing here, and the best that I know how, and much as the Holy Spirit will let me, I'm going to proclaim the good news that you don't have to die and go to hell. Jesus died for your sins and my sins on the cruel cross of Calvary, and we need to redeem the time and take time to find out where God brought us from, where he's going to take us, if we will only humble ourselves and search the scriptures, for in them ye have eternal life. And Jesus said, and they are they that testify me. I thank God that I have the testimony of Jesus Christ, as he is my Lord, my Savior, my Redeemer. He is the Holy One of Israel, and I love him, and I love God to Father and the sweet Holy Ghost from heaven that's in my bosom tonight. I thank God for the anointing of the Spirit of the living God, the Spirit of truth, and he will only bear witness. All these people out here that's prophesying out of their own spirit and not by the Spirit of God, and it not coming to pass, it's all the world, it's all the devil, and it's God's going to pass it away. He's going to burn it all up in the end. But today is a day of salvation. And now is acceptable time to come unto God. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest for your soul. Brothers and sisters, when you read the Word of God, believe what Jesus said and obey him. Obey is better than the sacrifice, and burn yourself with fire as a sacrifice unto God. We don't have them sacrifices anymore. Them sacrifices of putting people in the fire is all the devil. You need the fire of the Holy Ghost in you that'll burn all the sin out of your heart and life, and make you a new creature in Christ Jesus, and old things will pass away, and new things will become new in your body and your life. You'll become a brand new child of the King, a new creature in Christ Jesus. Praise God for the day that old things passed away, and all things become new in my life. And praise be unto his holy name, all things are of God anymore. Hallelujah. I don't love the world. I don't love the devil. I feel sorry for that man, that fallen angel, Lucifer. Y'all get ready to sing. God loves you, sinner friend. I love you, and I'm preaching my heart out to you. The best way that the Spirit of God will let me. You need to keep your eyes on Jesus. Don't you backslide. It'll take you further away from God than you want to go. Go ahead, brothers.
Someday when I drive.